second half, but at the end of the day we're coming here to reach the semi-final of the Champions League, and it's a great achievement for the club once again.
It was a clinical first half. Perfect. Don't you think?
Yeah, it was. It was really perfect. I think, as I say, I think we did the right things. I think when we were going forward, we looked dangerous. We had a lot of bodies going forward in attack, and we brought away our chances. So, yeah, we're really happy. And as I say, now we're looking forward to the semi-final.
But you can't be really satisfied with the second half, with conceding 3 goals.
No, and that's something that I'm sure that we'll look at. It's always difficult when you come in after a good first half like that, and you know that it's kind of impossible that they're going to come back. They would have had to score 7 goals, so probably a little bit of a mindset thing. But as I say, overall we're happy and glad to go away from here, having progressed to the next round.
That's probably Lyon in the semi-finals. They are leading 1-0 in Barcelona.
Okay.
So how do you see Lyon? You have played Lyon last year, didn't you?
Yeah, we played them last year, and we also played them in a pre-season friendly where I think we performed very well. So yeah, we'll be up for the challenge. Obviously in the Champions League you're going to face the best teams at some point, and we know it's going to be a tough game, but I think we'll be excited for it, because I think we've learnt a lot of lessons from last year. Maybe from the first leg we probably didn't get it right tactically and ourselves as well, so we know now what we have to do, and it'll be a good challenge for us.
It looks like a historical night for English football, because Chelsea's leading 1-0 against Montpellier, and there might be two clubs in the semi-finals.
Yeah, and we wish Chelsea good luck, hope that they get through. It's good for the English teams to be progressing, and yeah, hopefully we'll see what happens in the semi-finals. But we tend to only concentrate on ourselves, because we have big enough tasks ourselves to keep progressing through each round, and yeah, hopefully they can get through. But as I say, I'm glad that our name's in that last four.
You're also playing in the English national team. England is number 2 in the world right now. 2 English clubs in the semi-finals of the Champions League. What does it mean for English football now, for English women's football?
I think it's shown that we're progressing. We've got a plan where we wanted to keep moving up the rankings, and we've done that. There's been a lot of work gone in over the years. I've been lucky enough to be part of the national team for 11 years now, and to see the progression that it's made has been fantastic. And getting from second to first will be very difficult, because that's the final push, but we've just got to take each game as it comes. We've got an important game against Wales coming up, World Cup qualifiers, so we'll look at that one. And yeah, it's great for English football, and hopefully the rest of the world can see that we're trying to do things right here. And as you can see by the results, hopefully we're proving that.
5 years ago I met Emma Hayes, and she told me in 5 years from now the English league is going to be the best league in the world, and I didn't believe her.
Okay.
So, but now you're pretty close.
Yeah, as I say, we're trying to do the right things. I think after each season we'll review it, and the very open ideas from the clubs, and kind of just seeing what we can do better, because things can always be better, can't they? And with each year I think it has got better. So yeah, very happy the way it's going, and yeah, hopefully we'll just carry on in the right direction.
Thank you and good luck.
Thank you.